got to finish this. You got to finish this. Cause God gonna grade you. When you get through crying, you're gonna get a grade for this. When you get through suffering, you'll get a grade for this. When you get through going through, you're gonna get a grade for this. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, hang on in there. Because weeping may endure for a night, but joy. Somebody shout joy. Joy. Come on, shout joy. 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 Some of y'all heavy, but I ain't gonna tell nobody else to touch you. Talk yourself out of it. Some of y'all weeping now. Some of you frustrated. Some of you tired, but talk yourself out of it. Touch yourself and say, self, you're gonna be all right. Come on, talk yourself out of it. Talk yourself out of depression. Talk yourself out of frustration. Talk yourself out of giving up. Talk yourself out of letting up. Come on, talk to yourself and say, self, self, I got a feeling that every look at somebody tell me, I don't need nobody talking to me right now. I don't need no neighbor right now. There's enough anointing inside of me. Because the Bible says, out of your belly shall flow power in your mouth. If you say victory, then defeat is not an option. If you speak healing, then sickness is not an option. If you speak it, people, you gotta talk to yourself out of it. How can you encourage somebody else and you depressed? How can you encourage somebody else and you mad? Talk yourself. Look at your neighbor, tell a neighbor, if you can encourage yourself, you can encourage me later. But tell them, I'm all right. Tell them, I need you to talk yourself out of how you feeling right now. Come on, tell somebody, the season is over for encouraging others and you depressed. The season is over for lifting others and you feel low. Come on, talk yourself into victory. Talk yourself. You know how I feel when you get on the elevator and before it moves, before the elevator really moves, you feel a shift. The elevator hadn't moved yet. The only thing you felt was you felt the cables shift in a different direction. You ought to tell somebody, I got enough faith that I don't even have to start moving in the direction of my blessing. Just because I felt a shift, I felt my kingdom cables change direction. I just felt my kingdom cables change direction. And don't you be worried, because you got in the elevator and you push up, but somebody gets in your car and pushes down. And we're standing there trying to figure out which way is the elevator really gonna go. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, I don't know which way you're trying to go, but tell them, just because you are standing next to me, you have no choice but to go up. Now, tell them, neighbor, I do not know what direction you intended to go when you stood here. But tell them, since you're this close, because I'm anointed. Since you're this close, because I'm victorious. Since you're this close, because I have destiny. You have no choice but to go up. You and the rest of y'all have no choice, because I announce that destiny has been branded on me, and everybody attached to me, you have no choice but to go. feel your spiritual muscles flexing now. Don't you? The stuff that you came in here with that you felt like was impossible. Don't lie to me. Don't you feel like you can handle it right now? Don't you? Don't you? When you came in here, you didn't know how you was gonna work that out. But how you feel now? When I came in here, you was crying. But look at you now. Your hands up. You're dancing because you know that he's able. I'm trying to show you that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Look at your neighbor. And I'm going to leave you alone, but tell them, neighbor, because the Lord is here, I release you to dance over your trial. I release you to shout over your dilemma. Because where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And because God has given me authority, I can dance when I'm down. I can shout when I'm sad. Oh yes, because where? Give up, I'm gonna say no, keep going. You got to know there's so much power in my mouth. No matter what you want to do, when I speak it over you, something gonna shift inside of you. Because I think Lazarus was dead enough to decide to want to be dead, but Jesus walked up to the tomb and said, come. And Lazarus fell out of love with the grave and the grave clothes start coming out of him. Look at somebody and tell him, I'm getting ready to call you out of that. Come forth. Look at somebody and tell them, smile. For the rest of the year, you gonna smile. But the church ain't. Not the ones that God opened. Hallelujah. Folk done spoke about Jericho City, spoke to Jericho City, spoke on Jericho City. People come and go, but the anointing gets stronger. Y'all notice that? You need to be here. If you get off work at 7:30 and you be tired, bring your tired self on the church. I promise you that by the time church is over, you'll be glad you came. You're going to come back Thursday and Friday and bring a truckload of people with you. This is the week of revival for Jericho City. I need all of you to come and support the meeting. All of Houston is going to come, but I want to see Jericho City's face in the place.
What you do tonight signifies what you're going to do for the rest of the year. Get it in your hand. Let's go. Now give yourself some room, cause you got to walk up and you got to cut the head of depression off. You got to cut the head of stress off. You got to cut the head